We're here in Vermont, where there's a battle brewing that could determine the future of nuclear power for the U.S. At the center of this battle, this nuclear plant, the same design as Fukushima.
The Vermont Yankee Nuclear Power Station is 40 years old. Its operating license, issued by the U.S. Nuclear Regulatory Commission, or NRC, is set to expire this month. It's one of 23 Mark I design nuclear reactors in the U.S. The problems with this design are well known to industry insiders, including the NRC, according to government documents dating back to 1972.
1972, the NRC said we never should have licensed this Mark I design, period. But they also said we've got so many of them licensed already that if we were to change our mind, that would ruin nuclear power forever.
Arnie Gunderson is a former nuclear industry executive turned whistleblower with decades of experience in the industry. He's been appointed the chair of the state panel overseeing the Vermont Yankee reactor. He says because of design flaws, Vermont Yankee and other plants like it across the U.S. are one major earthquake, tornado, or flood away from disaster. And that's a fear bordering on reality after massive floods and tornadoes hit Vermont last year. If something were to go wrong at Vermont Yankee, this would be the damage area. And given its recent history under the ownership of a company called Entergy, there is reason to be concerned.
So let's go over this list one by one of all these mechanical errors.
We had 6 piping leaks in the plant, 3 piping leaks in the ground. Then we had the fire and the cooling tower collapse. And that's just in the last 5 years.
Is this normal?
It's not normal when cooling towers collapse. It's the only time in the history of nuclear power that a cooling tower has collapsed. But the key is why the tower collapsed. And in every case, we've been able to trace it back to inadequate maintenance. Every one of the major failures could have been preventable.
None of these problems would lead to a meltdown, but show a pattern of sloppy maintenance. We wanted to speak with Entergy's CEO, J. Wayne Leonard, but he declined our request. Despite its age and recent problems, last year the NRC granted Vermont Yankee a 20-year extension. So instead of closing in March 2012, it could now be open until March 2032.
Where I have had problems is that the NRC has, in some cases, become a cheerleader for the nuclear industry.
Clearly, the NRC has got to be vigilant and rigorous.
Vermont Senator Bernie Sanders sits on the Senate committee that oversees the NRC. He's worried as an older generation of America's reactors comes up for renewal.
They have always extended. When companies have come in and said, we would like an extension, I believe over 60 instances, they have granted everyone. And that's a problem. That's a problem.
We wanted to talk to the NRC. Over a 6-week period, we repeatedly requested an interview at any time or day of their choice, but we were told they were overbooked. So we decided to show up anyway and see if we could get some answers. A spokesman came outside soon after we arrived.
And we received the agency's response via our Director of Public Affairs, Elliot Brenner, and
yeah.
That's the answer for the agency.
Yeah, so no one's going to talk to us?
No.
I actually have the exact quote here on your site. It says that the NRC is devoted to open government, open, accountable, accessible.
Yes, all of our information is available on our website.
But if you guys are accessible to the public, how come you can't sit down with us for a 5-minute interview just to explain your side of the story?
Because the subject that you want to discuss is something that's currently a matter of litigation that the agency cannot discuss.
But we don't want to just discuss the Entergy plant, sir. We want to discuss overall how the NRC is regulating nuclear power in the United States.